So each iron bar is 0.25 weight units, so if we multiply that by 10, it's 2.5 for 10 bars. Multiply that by 7. It's 17.5, I guess. And a half, it's 18.75. And brick is 1.3, so 50 bricks. I think it was 0.13. Okay. So I think these come to nearly 25 weight units together. I'm wondering if I should craft the blacksmith bench beforehand, if it would reduce the weight of those iron bars and bricks. But maybe it won't. Is there basically anything that I'm missing that I should take with me when we head over? Oil, maybe? Sure. Yeah, I can't really think of anything else. Unless it's in the inventory of one of these thralls here. You have some fur. Fur is obtainable, so we don't need to bring it with us. And our armor seems to be a pretty decent condition. You are carrying only that much stone. I guess we can stock up on that. Okay. So let's head to the north. Oh, we managed to get to the bridge before it. Loaded those skeletons. And it's around here where I usually put down my base. Although this terrain is a bit uneven, we cannot go too close to the camp because it won't let us build there. And I prepare to make a tower of sorts, so that means using the wedges and normal foundations. Is it in equal measure? We'll start with these, then we'll extend it by one layer outward so that we'll maintain some foundational support throughout. You have to stand guard there. Now this is a bit uneven terrain, so we need to maybe elevate the ground level to make it better for the unevenness. So this is the center, and we'll extend it with these normal foundations in a star-like pattern. Then we'll fill these gaps with another wedge. And then we make some additional units. And what did I run out of? Stone. Replenish our stone with these 1000. And we'll connect the squares to these wedges so that it'll look nice. And now with these gaps we need 3 wedges each, so we need 18 wedges. and so on. These cubes are pretty compact, but mostly a circular shaped overall foundation for the tower. And then it's just about extending it upwards, floor by floor. It does have one weakness, however, and that's the method of how you go between the various floors it has, because it means that one part of the roof, the ceiling, has to be an opening, and that can break the foundational support rule. So it might be a good idea to just have one of these innermost wedge pieces also elevate throughout, just to make sure that you can attach the building pieces to where you need to have them. And I think I use a room size of two of these on top of each other, so that there's some room to maneuver. We're going to need at least one of these. And yeah, let's make you face the map room. Like so. Then we'll need some walls. Not sure what the circumference of this building was. Looks like. Is it 18? 1, 2, 3. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yeah, I think it's 18. We made 14 walls, but we only need 17 with the door taking one of those spots. And we are running out of stone for this endeavor. That gives us a half of our first floor. So now we need 18 additional pieces of wall. So I'm going to need a few stone for that. Fortunately, there are these stones scattered around, and with a good tool you should be able to amass enough of them. So how much did that wall cost to make? 18. And we need 18 of those. Yeah, we seem to be having enough. We're also going to need stone for the ceiling. So might as well keep harvesting. And let's equip the carrying capacity armor. Just to be able to move around a bit better. It's usually good idea in this game when you're building something to just have 50 carrying capacity so that you'll be able to move unhindered. And that means that you can just fill your inventory with all the various pieces that you might need. It's my stamina enough to get on top of this easily. And then we'll just put the second layer down, or at least try, but it's messing up the targeting. Then we are going to need the wedges, I think. Sandstone wedges. We make 11 initially. This is where I want the stairs to be, so we'll have to put those there as well. See how it comes together. Did I actually fuck this up? Yeah, I think I've fucked up the door placement. Because the square is now a bit wrong. Huh. I guess I am rusty. So we'll dismantle these ones. And lose some resources doing so. Make 3 walls and 1 door frame. And this is why we used the sandstone pieces initially and then just later on upgraded with the higher tier building pieces, so that when we make mistakes we don't really fuck up too badly. So we'll switch the door there. Fill these walls anew. Now that allows us to have this as their gear, and we'll be able to make a wedge here, and the other stair will be sort of possible to connect into it once the game starts behaving. I might need to have this wedge here for it, maybe. No, actually, here. And ceiling piece to connect it to. This isn't entirely right either. I messed something up from my earlier design. I'm just not really sure what it is quite yet. Or did I have this extended by one additional layer? I probably did. Well, this is embarrassing. I did feel like made this a little bit too fast. So missing one additional layer, and that would have enabled us to have two squares next to each other for the stairs to extend in a linear fashion. Well, we can still scavenge these pieces that we'll laid down for half the resources back, I guess. It's not ideal, but comes with the territory, I guess. If you fuck things up, you need to pay for it. So now my design might be a little bit too close to this incline. Which is not that great. So we'll make 12 of those to extend the entire thing. We are going to need some more stone. currently not having any of our weapons on our action bar. But that should make Tarman act.
You'll swing for me later.
Oh, he had 6 bricks. Right, so, 12 foundations. And we'll extend these wedges. Yeah, this one's going to be a bit of a bother. And we'll also get some these. It's 6 times 3, so 18. 18 again. Now it's wood that we're running low on. Stone. Your stone here. Yeah, this one's going to be an issue. It's probably won't let us connect to it easily because the ground's elevated. I'll have to figure out how to solve that issue. Might be possible to connect it from above, maybe. So if we have a piece here, then we might be able to make these and possibly connect to their bottom.